Yes, I'm here. Hello.
Look at you, all handsome. Look at
Can you hear
you.
me?
Yeah, I can hear you. You are on the tripod. I can see that. You're using your phone. You're
Yeah.
finally using your tripod.
Today for the first time I am using this tripod only because of Romil, because he has asked me several times, so I can't
Yeah.
wait any longer.
Ah, look at that. Thank you. Thank you for accepting my request finally. And you look so handsome. Look at that.
Oh my God, that's a very good compliment on a Diwali
Oh, you get ready for 2 days? Choti Diwali, Badi Diwali, and Pareva, Govardhan Puja. Yeah, but it's nice. It's nice. I just wore my dress for like 2 seconds or something. The moment food came, I was like, okay, I can't spoil this. I can't spoil this. I need to get back into my normal dress. So, yeah, I did
Okay.
not eat in that dress. But so basically, it lasted for like 2 minutes, my dress.
So you must have eaten so many sweet foods because you have a sweet tooth, I
What?
believe.
What?
I think you must have had sweet food. Sweet.
Sweets.
Yeah.
Yeah, many actually, many, many. A lot was given to us. We did not purchase anything from our side, but a lot was gifted to my father. And so something like that. And Clapingo also sent me a box of
Oh, clipping also said, wow, that's nice.
So I was like,
Okay.
okay, finally, finally, my efforts are being recognized. I'm pretty sure all the teachers got it, but I was like, yay.
Clipping is generous only for teachers, not for learners.
No, not at all. Not at all for learners. No, that's not how the things work. That's no, certainly not. So, how
Okay.
did you spend your Diwali?
No, I did not have, any special thing to do during Diwali. Only I lit some candles and put it on the wall, this much only.
Same here, same here. I'm really sorry, the pataka noise is too much. Everywhere it is like being blasted. It's not even being set on fire at this point, it's being blasted on your head. So yeah, and they are so enthusiastic about all Diwali is all about patakas these days. So I don't know when was the last time I had lit cracker or something like that.
You forgot the last time when you did
I think in 2019, like one anar, but I have like my enthusiasm towards patakas died like long back it died. So it's only about food and visiting friends. And so now it is not even that. It's like, shut up, stay in home, lock your room, sit inside, and do not call anyone.
it.
Yeah.
You just like to be alone.
Absolutely. Absolutely. There is no way. There's no other way.
Okay, I got it. Yeah, same here, but in my case it is different because I am now grown up. I am a old person, but in your case it is not sound good because you are a very young person, so you should enjoy the occasions like Diwali, these things. You should enjoy it,
Yeah, I
why
can
not?
enjoy. Of course, I can enjoy. But the thing is, I choose not to. It's a good thing. Like, how many, like, all my Diwalis, I have been someplace else. Like, I have already always frequented my friend's house and stuff like that. Okay. But now it was the time, like, to observe, to be a little observant towards Diwali. It was not only about pataka, it is not only about the crackers, it is not only about the mithai and the food and everything, but it is also about, okay, the recognition that, okay, something good will come. It'll take time, but something good is about to come. Okay, it'll take 14 years, like Sri Ram had to, he was waiting for something good to come after four, and he got it after 14 years. Okay,
Yes.
and it did not last long. Okay, like because this Ma Sita had to go away for after that. So that is like a big lesson for me, that, you know, a little amount of happiness can make you go a long, long way. Okay, because we as Indians, not as Indians, like as people, if we have been born, brought up on earth, then certainly a lot, like there's this quote, I don't know whether I've told you, it's by Rabindranath's story, or life is made out of eatings and beatings, with beatings predominating. Okay, it is in the Cast Away by Rabindranath Tagore. So yeah, there was this little boy who was an orphan, and somehow by luck, by grace, he got into this really big home, really rich home, all right, where the owner of the house used to box him for absolutely no reason. Okay, so he was like, life is made out of eatings and beatings, with beatings predominant. So that's, So I really love that quote. So that little amount of eating will let you, you know, will make you go through a huge amount of beatings. Okay, enough of my nonsense. Now your nonsense. Come on, tell me your nonsense.
I have nothing there, but I was waiting for this session. So it was long that I had a session with you for the last time. So I am, incidentally, it happened on a, it is, I think it's also a Diwali day today.
Yesterday it's also, Pareva. Diwali is officially over. Now Pareva is here.
Okay.
Yeah, so, Govardhan Puja.
So do you have the celebration that is called Bhai Dooj?
I've never done that. once I did that, but you know, when my cousin was here for once. Other than that, no, I have never done Bhai Dooj, no.
Okay, so did you have, you, as you said that once you did it, so you put tikka on your cousin's forehead. Did you do that?
No. I don't know. I don't think so. No. No.
So we do have this thing, this ritual that is called, in our case, in Bengali, we call it Bhai Phuta.
Bhai what?
Bhai Phuta.
Bhai Phuta.
When we put this, this is called Phuta.
Phuta. Chandan. So you put Haldi Chandan out here.
Okay. Yeah, this is called Phuta. So we call in Bengali it is Bhai Phuta. So this is well, yeah. So there is in my town in Guwahati, I had a cousin. So she has invited me to go to her place. So tomorrow I'll go to her place and she will put this Phuta on my forehead. So I'll give her something. She will also give me something and she will give me food to eat. This is the thing that this. Happen tomorrow.
Oh, okay. Once upon a time, I wanted to get married into Bengalis. My mother is a Bengali, so I thought that, okay, now my mother is not that, you know, she's not keeping up with the rituals, but I always wanted to get married into Bengalis because I wanted to know what Jamai Shoshti is all about. You see?
Oh!
It's a huge thing. And I just want to become a part of it, you know, just somehow I just want to become this and Annaprashan. Annaprashan, when that baby is born and Bengalis feed that little rice to a newborn, which sounds really dangerous, but I really want to become like these two celebrations. I really want to be a part of, I want to see, and Durga Puja. I want to see authentic Durga Puja, those 9 days of, you know, crazy celebration. I want to become a part of that. So, I don't know when will I get a chance.
When it comes to Jamai Shashti, it is the husband, that gets all the
attention. I really want to witness it.
Not only witness it, you will have to prepare so many foods at your place to please that Jamai, that is your husband.
What? It is all about food. Like every celebration is all about food being good.
Food and this gift, etc. What? Foods and gifts that you will, from your side, it is from her in-law's side, that is the groom. Groom is invited from his in-laws. So in-laws will invite him, and he will be treated with various kinds of food and with other gifts also. There will be clothes and whatever they feel like. He will be showered with gifts and food.
Not me. You males are showered with
from your side.
Okay, so did you have a grand Jamai Shashti yourself?
No, unfortunately, I have never went to my in-laws place to get all these facilities or to have this ritual. I did not have, they have invited me for sure, they invited me, but somehow I could not attend because their place is far away from my place, say 500 kilometers away from my place, so I cannot go. I could not go.
Okay. Were they village dwellers? Did they live in the village at that time?
Almost it's a village like place. Yeah, you can say that. Yeah.
Okay. And you were still in Guwahati?
Yes, I'm in Guwahati.
Okay. I thought that you must have transferred from a Kolkata, from like somewhere near West Bengal or something. Like you were in West Bengal, then you shifted to Guwahati, and then now. So nice. Anyway, so you never had your Jamai Shashti. Okay.
No.
But it is all about food at the end of the day. I was like, something must be more than that. You know, like a havan must be done for the husband or something.
Food and this during that time, it happened during summer time. So at the time, there will be mango, then lychees, and jackfruit like that. All of these things will be offered to the Jamai.
Okay. Nice. So Mr. Paul, now that we have talked about so many festivals, why don't you share a beautiful memory of any festival of your choice?
I don't have any very beautiful memory. Only when I was a child, I enjoyed Durga Puja very much. That I can share with you. What happened during that time, that we were we felt very happy at the before Durga Puja. So what happened at the time, that our parents bought new clothes for us. Okay, so Durga Puja is for 3 days. We call it Saptami, Ashtami, Navami, mainly in our place. Saptami, Ashtami, and Navami. So for 3 days, three different pair of dress. Shirt and trousers. So, and other say new shoes also. So we enjoyed at that time all these things. But nowadays, no more enjoying this.
Why? Because of the pollution and everything? Too much of crowd rush? I'm really afraid of rush, to be honest. I'm so afraid of rush, I can't tell you. I love Durga Puja, and for 2 years I have not been able to frequent a single pandal. I'm very scared of rush, especially only because of COVID. So,
it's not because of COVID, but I also don't like to go when it is so crowded in the pandal. So, this year also I visited 2 or 3 pandals only, and only for 1 day. Though it is for 3-4 days, but I visit only one day only.
Okay, here it is for 2 days. Yes, here it is for 2 days.
Only 2 days.
Yeah, I guess the Navami and the Ashtami, and I think so Saptami, but no, Ashtami and Navami, because many people do a 9-day fast. Many people do only 8-day fast. Okay. So I think the Biharis who keep the fast, they only fast for 8 days, and they break the fast on the 9th day. But I think the Bengalis, they fast for full 9 days and they break it, they open the fast or they break the fast on the 10th day. I think so.
Yes, but I've never seen any Bengali who are fasting. Yeah.
Here Bengalis fast. Here Bengalis fast. So, yes. And I have seen, like, they purchase gold during that time. At least here, like in Lucknow, Bengalis, they like to purchase. Yeah, and I have seen Bengalis dipping themselves in gold. And in Lucknow, you're wearing so much of gold. Oh my goodness. You know, somebody will come and whack it off. But yes, they do wear a lot of gold. Like one of my teachers, she had a gold watch made for herself. She was a Bengali and she had a gold watch made for herself. Can you imagine? And she wore that on Durga Puja.
Okay, yeah. So let me ask you that it is not about Bengali, but I think it is about the girls or women that love jewelry. So it may, I want to say that it is not about Bengali, but it is about girls or women who love jewelry. Okay, say gold, particularly gold. So what about you? You also like to.
Well, I am wearing this gold nathni since ages. I think my mother bought me this. So I've been wearing this, I think, more than a year now. And these are my mom's. So, and I do not wear. Yeah, these are my mom's. Actually, these are my nani's, I think so, if I'm not wrong. So, yeah. And somehow they just came. We were clearing out stuff and trash from her cupboard. I was clearing it out and I just found them. It was just lying in deep inside the corner. Even she didn't remember she had them. It was like, okay, give it to me. And she just gave it to me.
Okay. So you tell me, what about your flippingo? You love your flippingo.
I love flippingo. I really enjoy the classes. And it's telling me also, like today a girl said that I really like your classes, because I don't know, this was the last class and this was the second class with me. So 2 days ago she took a class and again she came back to me. I was like, okay, she said that she wanted to end the class with me. I'm like, okay. So I think these little, you know, these little ounces of happiness that you get along the way can make you really, you know, they can really make your day and everything.
So, yeah, that's true.
Yeah. So I felt nice. Like she said that your ideas are good when you teach. I'm like, okay, theek hai, thank you. Yeah.
But one thing I just feel like that, when you take classes, there are some learners who may be at a beginner level, okay? So when you talk to them, you should lower your level to be at par with them.
It is difficult, trust me.
Yes, yes. Because what happens is, I know your level is very high. So you will say something at one go, which they cannot catch up and they cannot understand. So sometimes they find it very difficult because your level is high. So they find it very difficult, yeah. So if you have to understand at what level they are, and understanding them, then you have to lower your level or higher your level like that. You will have to adjust. I think so. I don't know. I just felt like that. So I feel you.
No, you're right. I have got this. I think so. In a couple of videos also, I was told this or something like that. So yeah, that was her thing. I think one of the jobs that I was interviewing for, she said that you cannot use this language for kids. And so I was like, okay, I won't use it for kids. The problem is that I really would like to, otherwise my language would become, it'll affect me and my language. I will forget all the advanced words if I'm not going to use it.
That's a thing.
I will forget all the words. So I know it questions my mark as a teacher, but that's the reason that I'm not dealing, like, I want to become a professor and not a teacher of school, you know?
Your job is not here. Your job is somewhere else.
It is like coming from a place of understanding that you are sitting in my class. if I'm teaching, let's like just imagine my nice future. Okay. So if I'm just saying that, you know, if you're coming to my class, you have already, you are taking English as your major. All right. You have chosen it. So I will come from a school of thought that, okay, you have an access to basic English. You have an access to a normal English. You have an access to a language which is spoken in literature. So without which, why have you chosen this subject? Because we are not here to, you know, convince you into learning a course. We are here to drive you into, you know, another level. So that's the thing that you know, that is something like, I know this expectation is wrong. I was again like doing something and they were like, what is that one basic hurdle that you will face? I'm like, ma'am, expecting them to know something, to making sure that, you know, it was like applying for some Hindi job or something like that. Like, if they are not going to learn the script, how am I supposed to take the class forward from there? And I have no idea. That is like, you know, if they do not know English, basic English, I would be clueless. What should I do next?
But there are some, I have seen in some of the videos that they are at the beginner level. So whatever you tell that they cannot take, they don't understand, actually, frankly speaking, like this. So they find it very difficult. So next time when they, they think that whether I should go for the next class like this. So what I feel that you have to adjust at some.
Yeah.
Not with all, but with some learn.
Mm-hmm. I will. I'll definitely keep this mind. But it's difficult to tailor yourself at all times. That's the thing. Yeah. Yeah. I can do. I think I can do translation. Like I can teach them bilingually. Okay. Like once in Hindi, once in English. That can be done.